15% of the brain growth occurs. Thus, there is a need for promoting breastfeeding to enhance the brain growth. And the remaining 10% of the brain growth occurs in the preschool years, where special attention needs to be paid for complementary feeding and optimal micronutrient intake. So what are the general principles? Nutrients and growth factors regulate brain development during prenatal and postnatal life. And the rapidly growing brain is more vulnerable to damage and more amenable to repair following nutrition. So consumption to second week, umbilical cord is not formed and the mother's food intake does not have an effect on the embryo. Prenatal nutrition results in rapid development early in life and then it takes part in the main stages of development. You can see what are the foods necessary. Early brain development, the behavior and the brain development are interrelated. It depends upon interaction of many factors, genetics, experience, relationship, health and nutrition. And 60% of the nutrition used by the brain during the first year decreases to 30% by age 3. Now nutrition effects, what are the effects? It can affect on the neuroanatomy, neurochemistry and neurophysiology. Neurochemistry is regarding this neurotransmitter and receptor synthesis, neurotransmitter uptake mechanism, and the neurophysiology is changes in metabolism and signal propagation. All the nutrients are, though essential for optimal brain development, deficiencies of some nutrients at specific time may affect development of specific nature. Now, what are the particular nutrients which have effect on early brain development? There are micronutrients, macro and vitamins. Among the macro it is protein energy and specific fats, particularly LC-PUFA. Micronutrients, iron, zinc, iodine and vitamins, B, vitamin A, folate and choline. So we can see the role of the neuronutrients in brain, role in visual and motor development, myelin synthesis, memory fluidity, structural constituents, neural neurons, and synthesis of neurotransmitters. What are the fundamental questions? If a nutrient affects the brain, does it affect behavior? How close is the linkage for each nutrient, for each time period of development? Is the effect transient or is it long term? So what are the role of key nutrients for the first 3 years? These are cognitive development, visual development and language development. And nutrition for cognitive growth is after the most critical stage of cognitive development, only minimal size is left to be developed, that is by the age of 16, and thereafter it is required for maintenance. Why the brain needs protein? For DNA RNA synthesis and maintenance, for neurotransmitter production, for growth factor synthesis and for the structural proteins, that is neurotic extensions and synapse formation. And why the brain needs fat? Role of fat intake in the infants, consumption of long-chain polyunsaturated fatty acid results in faster brain stem maturation in infants. Both the N3 and N6 long-chain polyunsaturated fatty acid play a role in neuronal growth and synapse processing and gene expression. Requirement increases late in pregnancy and early in prenatal life, and infants depend on maternal ingestion of DHA, which is rich in fish oil. Now, prenatal and postnatal dietary deficiency of fat and brain development studies have shown that variation in this intake of fatty acids alters the fetal neural membrane composition and synaptogenesis. And in preterm infants, if supplementation of DHA is provided, the electro-retinogram activity and visual activity improves, that you can see in the graph how it is improving. Role of EFA in brain development is particularly on the development and function of brain, nervous system and the eye. DHA and A are highly concentrated in membrane phosphorylations of the brain and photoreceptor membrane of retina, where they accumulate rapidly during fetal and infant growth spots. Here we see the neuron myelination, which is increasing more, and you don't need damage myelination due to lack of fatty acid. Now, why brain requires folic acid? We used to know that folic acid required only due to anemia, but now we find it causes anencephaly, that is causing irregular brain deformation, stem cell division is impaired, resulting in lifelong brain impairment. Now, neurodegenerative defects from poor fluid intake occurs in first trimester of pregnancy. Sources are orange juice, meat, especially organ parts, and dark leafy vegetables. The requirement is 400 microgram per day. Needed before women realizes she is pregnant. Policy is for all young women to take folate daily and food fortification. Why the brain needs iron? Brain is required for energy, and this iron is found in cytochromes that make ATP. ATP production is high in fetus and neonate, and for neurotransmitters, for making dopamine, serotonin, noradrenaline, and for also myelin. Now we can see an event-related potential in newborn, where iron deficient has more potentials, and iron deficient shows lesser stimulations. Now, why the brain is called zinc? It interacts with DNA, that is called zinc phenoprotein, needed for growth factor, IGF-1 and TH, important for neurotransmitter release. It's called important for autonomic nervous system and development of the hippocampus. Fetuses of zinc deficient mothers demonstrate decreased fetal movement, decreased heartbeat variability, and altered autonomic nervous system stability. And postnatally, there is poor on memory. Source of zinc is mostly in most animal sources. However, cereals and legumes mixed with meat and vitamin C will enhance its absorption. Who is at risk in zinc deficiency? Offspring of zinc deficient mothers, protein malnourished infants, infants on prolonged total protein parental nutrition with inadequate zinc intake and short bowel malabsorption. It's a small thing about depression. Now, taurine is also a neuronutrient. It is conditionally essential amino acid made from cysteine and methionine. High concentration is found in infant brains and breast milk. Clinical data on infants and total parental nutrition with less taurine shows to have retinal changes and visual changes. Body does not make enough taurine and has to depend on dietary taurine. Enzymes needed for taurine synthesis are not expressed, and immature kidneys are unable to reabsorb it efficiently. Significant positive correlation is there between mental development and plasma taurine levels. Bacterial and fungal infection decreases its absorption. Monosodium glutamate, or what we call known as Ajinomoto, degrades taurine. In taurine deficiency, very detoxification pathway is hampered. That leads to autism in many cases. Requirement is 500 milligram per day. No taurine is there in vegetarian diet. Now, taurine is again a neuronutrient, helps in modulation of basic signaling process in the cells. It is found in phospholipids such as phosphatidylcholine or sphingomyelin, and serves to maintain the membrane structure. And it is also a component of the neurotransmitter acetylcholine, important for lung and memory. This is also found in mostly non-veg, meat and fish and eggs. Now, maternal choline deficiency and influence on brain development is, choline is especially important during the last trimester of gestation and the first 3 months of birth, when the rate of human brain growth is at its peak. Choline requirements during pregnancy and lactation are increased because maternal plasma choline is transported from the mother to the fetus and maternal stores may be depleted. Lactation further depletes these stores because milk contains a high level of choline. Infant plasma or serum concentration of choline in the fetus and the neonate are normally 6 to 7-fold higher than the choline level in adults, which suggests its important role in fetal development. And according to the DRI recommendation, adequate intake of choline is 450 mg per day during pregnancy and 550 during lactation. The carnitine, again a neuronutrient, it transports long chain polyunsaturated fatty acids in the mitochondria. It helps in formation of ketones, that is a source of energy for the brain. Infants have a decreased ability to synthesize carnitine and hence has to depend on the maternal intake. It is also stored in the fetus in late pregnancy, and source of carnitine is meat and fish. Iodine is an additional nutrient that affects brain and behavior. Development includes iodine, which mediates its effect through this thyroid hormone metabolism. Thyroid hormones coordinate different developmental events through specific effects on the rate of cell differentiation and gene expression. Then it is still a global problem, iron deficiency with negative socio-economic impact. It impairs industrial capacity, decreases the productivity and initiative. It is also significant for the poor pregnancy outcome, causing severely getting infants, children and adults. Globally, due to lack of iron in the food, soil and water, sea in land which is away from sea, highly prevalent in mountainous areas, receiving water from melted snow and ice, and hence the entire food chain is affected with low iron content. Vitamin A and red development, it is involved in gene expression, cell differentiation, proliferation, migration and death. However, excess retinoids or its deficit can result in brain anomalies and psychosis. And there is a report that is the lower IQ in vitamin A deficient children. Vitamin deficiency is seen again in vegetarians, although in low animal source food. Key role is in brain and CNS development, red cell formation, immune formation, and recently found to play a role in brain development and cognitive function in children. Low breast milk B12 is a risk to the infant. So approach is promote animal source foods in diet, consider milk of any variety. What is the key point? Key point is to match nutrient with specific developing brain region that is dependent on the nutrient. Use specific brain assessments that are sensitive to the nutrient deficiency, and testing of specific brain areas can be done at a very young age but becomes more reliable as the child grows. What are the principal problems?